This is the Proverbs of the day for September 18th, 2014. I gotta play catch up now because of the internet and stuff. So let's get into this.
Proverbs chapter 18.
Through desire, a man having separated himself seeketh and intermeddleth with all wisdom.
A fool hath no delight in understanding, but that his heart may discover itself. When the wicked cometh, then cometh also contempt, and with ignominy, reproach.
The words of a man's mouth are as deep waters, and the wellspring of wisdom as a flowing brook.
It is not good to accept the person of the wicked, to overthrow the righteous in judgment. A fool's lips enter into contention, and his mouth calleth for strokes.
That's very interesting. These whole verses right here are just 1 through 6 are very interesting when you think about it. Through desire, a man having separated himself seeks and meddles with all wisdom, and it quarrels with the wisdom. And that can happen a lot of times through like sin, you know, like you'll get involved in sin in your life, and then you basically quarrel with the wisdom that the Lord gave you, you know, because you pretty much know what to do is right, but you know many times it says that a righteous man falleth 7 times, you know, but gets back up. That's the main part, is that you get back up and don't just stay down, you know. Don't just let the world beat you down. Don't just let you know, problems in life, like I had problems last week or so, don't let those just beat you down, you know. Come back stronger and happier.
A fool's mouth is his destruction, and his lips are the snare of his soul. The words of a talebearer are as wounds, and they go down into the innermost parts of the belly.
That's true. You know, gossip basically, you know, tears you up inside. You know, even if you're gossiping with somebody else, eventually it makes you feel bad about yourself or bad about talking about somebody else. It just tears you up all inside.
He also that is slothful in his work is brother to him that is a great waster.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe.
Amen.
The rich man's wealth is his strong city, and as an high wall in his own conceit. Before destruction, the heart of man is haughty, and before honor is humility.
Amen to that.
He that answereth a matter before he heareth it, it is folly and shame unto him.
The spirit of a man will sustain his infirmity.
But a wounded spirit who can bear?
The heart of the prudent getteth knowledge, and the ear of the wise seeketh knowledge.
I don't know about y'all, but this makes me feel a whole lot better. Just like listening to it and reading it, it makes me feel a whole heck of a lot better. And I don't know, it's amazing how, like, you know, the Holy Bible can bring you out of anything, you know, and Jesus and God, you know, and the Holy Ghost can just pull you out of any situation, and he loves you no matter what you do, you know, and I just think that that's a great blessing, and it's a great blessing to have, you know, people to share this information with, too. Okay, let's go on.
A man's gift maketh room for him, and bringeth him before great men.
He that is first in his own cause seemeth just, but his neighbor cometh and searcheth him. The lot causeth contentions to cease, and parteth between the mighty. A brother offended is harder to be won than a strong city, and their contentions are like the bars of a castle. A man's belly shall be satisfied with the fruit of his mouth, and with the increase of his lips shall he be filled. Death and life are in the power of the tongue,
Amen.
And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof.
And we can put that too with James, like we talked about before in another video. We could put that with James. It's very interesting how James and Solomon, you know, kind of talk about the same things, but James kind of compacts it together, you know.
Whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing, and obtaineth favor of the Lord.
The poor useth entreaties, but the rich answereth roughly.
A man that hath friends must show himself friendly, and there is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother.
And who is that? That's Jesus. Okay, so I feel better, you know, about that and doing that, and hopefully I get caught up pretty soon. And thank you guys for continuing to watch, and just be blessed out there. Wake and watch for Yeshua. God is love, and I love God. Amen.